Good morning, students. So this is another video on the practice questions, that is MCQ type, on the chapter The Fundamental Unit of Life, and this is part 3 for class 9, presented by me, Pooja Verma. So before we start, as you know that you need to follow certain rules, that you need to use a sheet of a paper and pen while answering the questions, and if you have marked the right answer, give yourself plus 1, and if you attempt it wrong, or unattempted questions will be marked as 0. There will be no negative marking. Apart from that, listen very carefully at the end of the questions in which I am giving to the explanation, and don't forget to tell your marks in the comment section below along with your name. So let's get started. So the first question is, cell arise from the pre-existing cells was stated by, and the options are A, Haeckel, B, Virchow, C, Hooke, and D, Sclidin. Students, take 3 to 4 seconds and mark the right answer. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option B, that is Virchow. Students, you know very well that Rudolf Virchow has proposed a phrase, that is in Latin, that is hominis cellula e cellula, which means that all the cells is being arising from the pre-existing cells. Okay, moving forward to the next question. Cell theory was proposed by, and the options are A, Sladen and Swan, B, Virchow, C, Hooke, and D, Haeckel. You need to mark the right answer over here. Okay, I wish you have marked the correct answer. So the answer for this question is option A, that is Sladen and Swan. Sladen and Swan, in the year 1838 and 1839 respectively, proposed a cell theory that all the living organism is composed of the cell, and cell is the basic structural and the functional unit of living organism. Later on, Rudolf Virchow add another phrase, that is hominis cellula e cellula, which means that all the cell is being arising from the pre-existing cell. Clear? Third question. The only cell organelle seen in the prokaryotic cell is. Prokaryotes mein kaun sa sirf cell organelles hame achhe se dekhne ko milta hai? First one, mitochondria. Second, B, ribosomes, C, plastids, and D, lysosomes. Take your time, students, and mark the right answer. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is B, ribosomes. Only ribosomes are clearly visible in the prokaryotes. Okay, students, the next question is, organelle without a cell membrane is option A, ribosome, option B, Golgi apparatus, option C, chloroplast, and D, nucleolus. Here you need to tell that which organelle, which cell organelle is lacking cell membrane. Take your time, take 3 to 4 seconds and mark the right answer. Okay, so the answer for this question is option A, ribosomes. Okay, ribosome is a cell organelle that lacks cell membrane. Clear? Next question is, 1 micron meter is A, 10 to the power minus 6 meter, 10 to the power minus 9 meter, 10 to the power minus 10 meters, and D, 10 to the power minus 3 meters. So this is mathematical factual question. You need to know that 1 micron meter consists how many meters. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option A, that is 10 to the power minus 6 meters. 1 micron meter is equals to 10 to the power minus 6 meters. Clear? The next question is, lysosome arises from, and the options are A, endoplasmic reticulum, B, Golgi apparatus, C, nucleus, and D, mitochondria. Take your time and mark the right answer. So the right answer for this question is option B, that is Golgi apparatus. Okay, so lysosomes arises from the Golgi apparatus. Next question. Question 7. Living cells were discovered by option A, Robert Hooke, option B, Purkinje, option C, Leeuwenhoek, option D, Robert Brown. Students, this question is a little bit tricky, okay? Just mark your answer, then I'll let you know. Living cells were discovered by. Mark the right answer. And the answer for this question is option C, that is Leeuwenhoek. I know that most of you have marked option A. But students, see the question. Here the living cells were asking. And Robert Hooke is the founder of the cell. Obviously, he proposed the term cell. But Robert Hooke observed the dead slice of the cork, not the living organelle. But Antony von Leeuwenhoek observed the pond water, rainwater, pond water, in which he see the living cells and he named that living cells as animalcules. I think now the entire story will be clear to you, isn't it? So, option C, that is Leeuwenhoek, is the right answer. Moving forward, question 8, select the odd one out. Okay, odd one, you need to select it. The option A is, the movement of water across a semi-permeable membrane is affected by the amount of substance dissolved in it. B, membranes are made up of organic molecules like proteins and lipids. C, molecules soluble in organic solvents can easily pass through the membrane. And D, plasma membranes contain chitin, sugar in plants. So read the question, students, very carefully and then mark the answer. The correct answer for this question is option D, that is plasma membrane contain chitin sugars in plants. So this is the odd one out. So aisa kuch bhi nahi hota hai plants mein, theek hai? Plasma membrane chitin sugars nahi contain karte. Clear? Next question is, ninth question. The barrier between the protoplasm and the outer environment in an animal cell. Keep in mind, here animal cell is being referring. The options are A, cell wall. Option B, plasma membrane. Option C, nuclear membrane. And option D, cytoplasm. Read the question again and mark the right answer. So right answer for this question is option B, that is plasma membrane. Students, here we are talking about the animal cell, and you know very well that animal cell do not contain any cell wall. Cell wall is the prominent feature of the plant cell, not of the animal cell. Animal cell do not have any sort of cell wall. Okay, so here answer B, that is plasma membrane, is the correct answer. And the last question for this video is, green colored plastids are known as, options are A, chromoplast, B, chloroplast, C, leucoplast, and D, protoplast. Read the question. Options might be confusing, but it is not if you clear with your concepts. So green color plastids are known as. Okay, so the answer for this question is, answer is the option B, that is chloroplast. Chloroplast is the green colored plastids containing the green color pigment, photosynthetic pigment, that is chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is responsible for trapping the sunlight and helps in the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process through which plants synthesize their own food, because plants are autotrophic. Autotrophic ka matlab hota hai, those organisms which can able to synthesize their own food. Clear? So students, this is the entire 10 questions for your practice. And at the end, don't forget to mention your score in the comment section below along with your name. Okay, if you have done the answer correct, give yourself plus one there. Each question carries one mark each. Okay, and if you have attempted wrong or if you unattempt any question, then give yourself zero there. Fine, and mention your score in the comment section along with your name. So thank you so much. And until next time, God bless you all. Thank you.